I decided to have UPC square in my laboratory because with the experience I had with supercritical fluid chromatography for more than 20 years, we needed really a rugged instrumentation, a robust instrument, and in order to improve the performance. Because often we used homemade apparatus or apparatus where the performance were really not adapted to quantitative analysis, as an example. The method was not enough robust to validate a method. It was our goal to test this technique as we tested UPLC and to compare also the performance of the technique with UPLC, with GC, or with other techniques, in order to demonstrate the advantages and the limitations of the UPC square.
ACQUITY UPC squared is a new device, new instrumentation. It is based on the philosophy of ultra high performance liquid chromatography, and this new technology makes the bridge between liquid chromatography and gas chromatography from a theoretical point of view.
The main advantage of the product we observed is it is really easy to handle, it is easy to inject, it is not so easy normally to inject in supercritical fluid chromatography because we are not in a liquid or in a gaseous system. And therefore the injection part, it's a very important point. And with this system, we were very satisfied about the injection system. And also the system is very robust, which is quite important to be reproducible when you perform a lot of analysis to have very reproducible results, and it was the case.
When you move to the UPC square, you will see that sensitivity that you can attain will be very close to what you can have in LC. Generally, they will be in the same range of, in the same order of magnitude, depending, of course, on the nature of the compound that you will employ. But the sensitivity that you can expect with a UV detection will be almost similar, which is a good benefit compared to what you can have with a very old SFC instrument. Second, when you are doing some experiments with this UPC square, you can do 10 successive experiments with the same sample. If you overlay your chromatogram, you will have a perfect overlay. I mean that for people who know the UPLC technology, this is exactly the same. You do 10 successive injections, you cannot see any difference between these 10 injections in terms of retention time and also in terms of peak area, which means that finally we can even imagine to use now FFC for quantitative analysis, which was something very difficult with all generation of SFC. If you look at different papers in the literature, you will see that finally SFC has never been employed or very scarcely employed for quantitative evaluation because we don't have always a very good repeatability with this instrument. With the UPC square, we have tried to do some quantitative evaluation, and as we expect, finally the performance were very good and this met the requirement, for example, of pharmaceutical industries and things like this.
From a practical point of view, I think that the convergence chromatography, which is the name of this technology, which is between the two other techniques, is something more because, of course, from a theoretical point of view, it's a liquid separation assisted by a gas, which is in a supercritical state. But the mechanisms that are involved in the separation are far from the liquid mechanism or classical mechanism and gas mechanism. It's close to liquid, but with slight differences.
So this is the most important benefit. And of course, there is another thing. You can use some column packed with sub-2-micron particles, which are also available. So when you work with sub-2-micron particles and you use CO2 as a supercritical fluid, finally you have both the advantage of sub-2-micron particles and the advantage of the CO2, which provide a lower viscosity compared to mixture of acetone acryl and water. So you can have some faster separation compared to what you will have in conventional SFC with 5-micrometer particles.
It's very, very easy, very plug and play and straightforward to use. And now with the new design of new generation of instrumentation like the ACQUITY UPC2, everything is very easy to use or to manage.
Another point in order to have UPC2 in a laboratory is that the method we are developing for, as an example, for the analytical aspect, could be directly transferred to preparative chromatography. In my opinion, it is a real advantage. As an example, I worked for many years with capillary electrophoresis, which is also a good technique, complementary technique to liquid chromatography or GC, but we cannot use this technique for preparative, as an example. And in my opinion, UPC2 has this great advantage.
We are in the School of Pharmaceutical Science, so what we have done is simply to work a lot now with drugs, which are mostly basic compounds, and try to see what can be done with this kind of analytes. And we were positively surprised because we can add some additives inside your mobile phase. When you work with CO2 and methanol, you can add, for example, small amount of ammonia, and at the end you will drastically improve the peak shape of your basic compounds. So we have seen that finally this technology can be well adapted for the analysis of basic drugs, which are really of interest when you are involved in the pharmaceutical field.
For everyday use, UPC2 is, in my opinion, a very good tool because we can do repeatable analysis, which is quite important. It is easy to operate, which is also another advantage, because often it is not so easy to practice this kind of separation. And it is very robust also. And then we can perform quantitative analysis, which are very with same kind of performance than other techniques.
The ACQUITY UPC2 open new frontier in terms of selectivity, and it's compared to classical separation techniques, because it's a special separation mechanism. That it's more, if we are talking to liquid chromatographer, it's more considered to be normal phase mode, and to all liquid chromatographer, generally normal phase is. Yeah, they are a bit afraid of that because of the use of special solvents and that are toxic and all that stuff. And now it's a good way to achieve separation that are not achievable with classical reversed phase liquid chromatography. With this new technique, with the new selectivity that are possible to achieve.
When we move to this new technology, the first very impressive things were the level of sensitivity that we can attain. We had something like 10, 20 times more sensitive experiments compared to what we were doing before in conventional SFC. So it means that now we are in line with what we can do in LC or UHPLC. This was the first argument. Second, we have also some very impressive performance. I mean that we can work with column packed with radius particle size, compact with sub-2-micron particles, and using this kind of technology, we can have some very impressive performance. At the end, we have shown, for example, that separation of, 5-6 peak could be realized in less than 1 minute, less than 30 seconds even. So you can go really faster than what you are doing normally in HPLC or SFC. You can also do some very high-resolution separation. We have coupled in series several columns for UPC2 instrumentation, and we have seen that the number of peaks that you can separate becomes very impressive.
The advantage of UPC2, effectively, we can have three advantages: orthogonality, chirality, and preparative. For orthogonality, it is very important to have all the panel of all techniques, analytical techniques, in order to be sure to You have not to miss a compound, or you have to be sure to have the complete, the comprehensive information. It is quite important in different domains. So you need the different techniques such as liquid chromatography, gas chromatography, capillary electrophoresis, and UPC2 also, which is orthogonal.
So at the moment, what we are doing now, we have checked the system. We think it is really a very good system. It provides some excellent repeatability, excellent sensitivity. So the system works correctly. There is absolutely no problem with that.